Hello students, welcome back to the chapter The World of Microbes. So previous class of this chapter we learned one of the microbes, that is bacteria. In today's class we will learn about two more bacteria, that is fungi and algae. So first we shall read the content. Take out your textbook and look for the page number 254 and read along with me.
Fungi. For many people, fungi are mushrooms and toadstools. But mushrooms and toadstools are only the visible parts of fungi. Most fungi are microscopic. Fungi do not prepare their own food. They depend on ready-made supply of food. So you can see there are different types of fungi, students. They break down the remains of dead plants and animals into simpler substances. Fungi do not only feed on dead matter but attack living plants and animals and often cause diseases. So penicillin. The first antibiotic drug is obtained from a fungus. Yeast are used to produce alcoholic drinks and to make bread rice. Some fungi are used to flavor food. Yeast is used in the preparation of dosa. Algae. Algae are plants. They are different from fungi because they can make their own food using chlorophyll. Algae play an important role in medicine, industry, and as food. Look for the red box, students. Let's make it simple. Sir Alexander Fleming, birth dated 1881 to 1955, who was a Scotsman, studied medicine. He noticed that a dish of bacteria in his laboratory had accidentally become infected by a fungus. He saw that the fungus had killed the bacteria near it. Fleming isolated the substance produced by the fungus. He called it penicillin. The first antibiotic drug, penicillin, has saved millions of lives.
Now we shall look for the explanation. Listen it carefully and note down all the points which will be highlighted in the upcoming animated slides and video.
Fungi. Many people say fungi, fungi, fungus. All these things are same. Okay, you can pronounce in any manner. Okay. So fungi. Fungi is a type of a microbe that grow on dead and decaying plants and animals. Some examples are yeast, mushrooms that you eat, wheat mushrooms, and mold, etc. So mold grows on plants, wood, fabric, and also on food like slice of a bread. Next is some fungi attack the skin and causes disease like ringworms, achy skin, and other skin infections.
Algae are eukaryotic organisms. Some algae are prokaryotic, for example cyanobacteria. And about these you will learn more in your higher studies, students. Most algae are photoautotrophic, that means they can carry on photosynthetic process and they can prepare their own food by using sunlight and chlorophyll. Now what is chlorophyll, students? Chlorophyll, it is a pigment present in all the green plants which will help in preparing their food by using the sunlight. Okay. So at one time algae were thought to be plants but are not, because they lack roots, stems and leaves. Students, here you can see the picture of algae. As I told you, algae is nothing but the generally we can say pachy. Okay, here you can see how it is formed. What are algae? Algae are organisms that are like plants and vegetables. They are commonly found living in the sea, rivers, lakes or ponds. All algae make energy from the sun. But there are two different types of algae and they are called macroalgae and microalgae. As you can see here, macroalgae are commonly known as seaweeds. In fact, the word macro means big. So you can think of a big plant that lives in the sea. Whereas microalgae are often called phytoplanktons. Here micro means small. So for this we must have to use microscope to see.
That's about today's class. The further content about still more other types of microbes that we will continue in the next class. Thank you.